Greetings, music lovers. Rick Ferguson, rickfergusonmusic.com. Thank you for joining me in this request video. I received an email from a YouTube viewer, Letitia. Letitia, thank you so much, and thank you for your excitement and interest in specifically Wolfgang Mozart's 40th Symphony, K550. Wonderful piece. I love this piece. It is absolutely one of the more identifiable, familiar works by Mozart. And one of the things that I love about this piece, especially in the first movement, but really throughout, Mozart really is almost doing a Beethoven. He's taking these motivic ideas and developing them. So, for instance, in the first movement, of course, we have this iconic motive that Mozart then takes rhythmically, melodically, harmonically, and develops throughout the movement. It's incredibly clever. Let's listen to a performance of the exposition of the first movement, just the first portion of the first movement, and let's hear how Mozart really has fun dealing with this, but also there's a significant, I would say, emotional component to this piece, because it seemed that Mozart saved G minor for some of his more emotionally or psychologically involved pieces. Not that many of them, but when he wrote in G minor, it really seemed to mean something. So here we have recording Leonard Bernstein leading the Boston Symphony, first portion of the first movement of Mozart's G minor symphony, K550. Enjoy. So you're hearing all the development that's going on of that idea. Now, let's fast forward to the fourth movement, to the last movement of this, which is just an absolute orchestral romp. Very exuberant tempo, but one of the most fascinating things in all of Mozart for me is what happens about midway through this last movement. And all of a sudden, it seems that Mozart is taking the primary motive in this last movement, but he moves through all 12 tones of the chromatic scale. Not literally chromatically, but he does not repeat any tones until he moves through all 12 of the chromatic tones of an octave. So let's hear this. So again, this is Bernstein with the Boston Symphony, and at the tail end of this, you will hear how Mozart is moving through what I can only describe to myself as a tone row. And he moves through all 12 tones, and I just love it. I think it's absolutely fabulous. All right, so give a listen. How much fun is that? Please, if you have never given yourself the treat of listening to this particular symphony all the way through, do listen to it in its entirety. It's an absolutely wonderful work. It is so much fun, and it's such a beautifully crafted symphony. Now, it is not the only G minor symphony that Mozart composed. The K550 was written in 1788 in Vienna. But when Mozart was much younger, 1773, he wrote his first G minor symphony. And this is also a very, very familiar piece, in particular if you know the soundtrack from the movie Amadeus at all. This piece certainly shows up there, and it's this syncopated rhythm that's going on in the first movement that really is the hallmark of this piece. And it certainly lends a certain degree of intensity to the music. Ya ba 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 ya ba 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 ya ba 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 ba. And he just keeps working with this syncopation throughout that first movement. And actually, the syncopation continues to show up in various ways later on in the rest of the symphony. But let's listen to this. Let's listen again to the exposition of the first movement. And here we have Leonard Bernstein again, this time with the Vienna Philharmonic. So here we have much earlier G minor symphony written in 1773 in Salzburg before Mozart went to Vienna. And this is K183. Enjoy. Now, I would be remiss if I did not mention that I feel that certain rhythmic elements, especially that syncopated element in the rhythm, surfaced in other pieces. In particular, another minor key piece of Mozart that was written a little bit later, his 20th piano concerto, albeit in D minor, I can't help but think that Mozart, to a certain degree, was recycling just a little bit of material to create a bit of drama. And I want to listen to this. So let's hear a little bit of the first movement of Mozart's K-466, the D minor piano concerto. This is the wonderful Mitsuko Uchida, and she's with the Kammerata Salzburg. And this is sort of into the exposition, the first entrance of the piano. But after the piano has the solo statement, I want you to listen carefully to what's going on in the orchestra, and you will hear that syncopated figure. And again, I can't help but think that Mozart is wanting to use what he had done in that earlier symphony and sort of recycle it here to great effect. So, Mitsuko Uchida and Kammerata Salzburg. G minor shows up in a couple of other significant pieces. One of my favorites and one of the pieces that I just love to play is actually his G minor piano quartet. So piano, violin, viola, cello, so much fun to play. And the first movement in particular is a little bit on the intense side. So he's really embracing the G minor vibe. I want to listen to a little bit of the first movement again. This was written in 1785. The K number is 478. And here we're going to have a performance from the Hochstein Music Festival with Alina Pogoskina, violin, Veronica Hagen, viola, Misha Meyer, cello, and Jerome Ducrot, piano. And it's beautifully played. So this is the first portion of the G minor piano quartet by Mozart. Enjoy. Thank you. And now finally, we move to what is, I believe, my favorite late Mozart piece, his string quintet with two violas, two violas. The K number is 516, written in 1787. I just absolutely adore this piece, and this is a beautiful interpretation by the Mellos Quartet, with the extra violist being Franz Beyer. And this is again the opening movement, sort of the first portion, the exposition of the Allegro movement. And it is just such beautiful writing. It's very tender writing, and the back and forth between the strings is just so touching to me. I love this music dearly. So this is the first movement, string quintet in G minor for two violins, two violas, cello by Mozart. Do enjoy. So those are some works, Letitia, that you might enjoy, specifically in G minor, exploring. And you also mentioned, before I forget, that your son is a trumpet player. Good for him. And I was thinking about this. Mozart's father, Leopold, he composed really quite a lovely trumpet concerto. I don't know if your son is familiar with this, but he might enjoy becoming familiar with Leopold Mozart's trumpet concerto, and maybe compare Leopold Mozart's trumpet concerto with that of Joseph Haydn, and sort of see what he thinks about those two pieces. It's a lot of fun listening, and I like that comparative listening as well. So, Letitia, thank you so much for your question. Everybody, I hope if you aren't familiar with these wonderful works in G minor by Mozart that you'll take a little time and search them out and really listen to them because it's beautiful music. So thank you for watching, and I would love to get more suggestions for music to talk about a little bit. So thank you for watching. Bye-bye.